We do read alouds all the time about being the change and what it means to be the change in your community. And all of these lessons have gone farther now that they have this concrete experience that they can draw upon.
Across the street from our school, there's a lot of abandoned lots. And there was one full of garbage and glass, and there was two mattresses in there and needles.
Like, first it looked like rubbish, a dead bird.
And then the community of Sikh Academy, they got together and they cleaned it up.
We spent a couple of Saturdays in there just elbow grease and shovels. I taught a lesson about the Lorax to a kindergarten class. And at the end of the Lorax, there is a seed, the last seed of a forest that has been cut down.
Now that you're here, he's talking to you guys. The word of the Lorax seems perfectly clear.
Unless someone like you cares a whole awful lot, nothing is going to change. It's not.
You're in charge of the last of the truffula seeds.
And I told that to the kids, and we brought out a seed.
It was the seed from the Lorax, right? The last seed. And so we very gingerly passed the seed around, and the kids were just mesmerized. Like, this is the last seed.
And they all sent love to it and whispered their hopes and dreams for the world into it. And that was the first seed we ever planted in the garden. They planted the seeds, and they just out of nowhere, they all started talking to the plants.
I'm back. I love you. I want you to grow real big and be a star. It'll be wonderful.
And they said all those things without even seeing what could happen. They were already invested, but the moment they saw the sprouts come out, like the look on their faces, they were just shocked. And they just start hysterically laughing because they're just so full of joy that this happened. It's beautiful.
We're about to go garden, Miss Chattery.
It makes me happy and it also makes me proud.
There's so many obstacles, like we didn't think that much about water, and then we had to brainstorm and get the Newark Fire Department. But before that, 30 kids would carry those little watering cans down the stairs every day.
What is the lesson the Lorax is trying to teach us?
And I think it's never give up because we never gave up trying to help the world.
Every time I'm out there, people from the block are walking by saying things like, when are the vegetables gonna be ready? How can I help? One woman, she came down and she walked by and she was crying and she's like, my son woke me up and he said, Mom, you have to see this. And she was older and she came by and she said, nobody has ever paid attention to this corner of the street before. And thank you for building us a hope garden.
I want to live in a beautiful world and also I want to live in my world I'm in right now.
Unless someone like you cares a whole awful lot, nothing is going to change. It's not.
It's just like the Lorax. It's like I can make plans, do good deeds with plants, and then help the world get better.
Changing the world isn't an enormous thing. You can just plant a seed in your backyard and make a beautiful place. And I think that's when they started to understand what it means to be the change.
Could be anything in life and you can make a better place anywhere you go and anywhere you're coming from.